Testing 1, 2, 3. Al was a pretty fair golfer in his day.
Testing 1, 2, 3. You can't always believe everything Al says.
Testing 1, 2, 3. Al's golf rounds often started off slowly, but better when the bets increased on the back nine and he really excelled on the 19th hole.
All I wanted was to audition. Now I am suing for sexual harassment.
At an early age, it was evident that Al would be active in sports due to his small size. The choice would eventually be between baseball and golf. My oldest brother Lee was probably the best athlete in the family. In high school, he played football, basketball and baseball. In 1951 he led the Florida State Seminole baseball team in hitting. This junior tournament was held at Indian Creek Country Club. For many years after, Al enjoyed quite a bit of success there. Julius Borrows was the current US Open champion. As he also liked fast play, I knew this would be a fun time. First place was a bunch of frozen steaks. We decided to have a cookout on the trip back to Des Moines. We used the dashboard defroster in Allendale's company station wagon to thaw the steaks. Then stopped at a rest area on Interstate 35 and fired up a grill. This was Al's first time to play in a national tournament, and away from the state of Iowa. The amazing thing was Al would be paired against Leo Zampedro, a college friend of his brother, Jim. Jim drove all night from Nyack, New York to Pittsburgh for this 36-hole match. Al would partner with his sister, Nancy, and they shot an amazing 3 under par 69 at Jones Park to win by 9 strokes. This was a straight alternate shot tournament. Al's college golf was very mediocre, as his transferring of colleges permitted him only his senior year at the University of Iowa. He did acquire two football teams to root for, Arkansas and Iowa. Finally, after a second and third place finish in this tournament, Al gets a victory. Not only that, but smashes the existing record by 6 strokes. Al says he is tired of winning black and white portable television sets, and wants to play for cash. Playing some of the great golf courses in Chicago, Al takes his game to a new level. Al misses tying the course record in Itasca Country Club by 1 shot. The record is held by Bob Harris, his boss at Sunset Ridge. Bob and Al tie for first place in the Illinois Pro Assistance Championship at Cog Hill. Al had never even seen a PGA Tour event, and now will be competing in the US Open at Hazeltine Country Club in Chaska, Minnesota. Pretty good company, with winds up to 40 miles per hour in the opening round. Al had the misfortune of an afternoon tee time in the first round. Winning the Illinois Open was a major accomplishment, adding the qualifying for the US Open and advancing to the finals of the PGA Tour school. He was given a sponsor's exemption to the 1971 Western Open. Some very impressive names of former Illinois Open champions: Jack Fleck, Erie Ball, Felice Torza, Bob Harris, Gary Hallberg, Dick Hart and Bill Ogden. These are some of the country clubs that I'll work at. I landed a sales position covering 5 states for Dunlop. Talk about highway miles. After 2 years with Dunlop, Al got his dream job with Titleist and moved back to Iowa. Al would win the Des Moines City Championship 3 of the first 4 years that he played in it. The tournament was held at Waveland Golf Course, which was very similar to Alice Park in Cedar Rapids where Al learned to play. A couple of years later, Doug Dunucky shot a 59 on the PGA Tour, and I was back to shooting 80 and drinking beer. It is about over now. Fishing is more fun, anyway. At age 60, Al shot a 62 which included 2 bogeys. The remarkable thing about this round was that in the first 7 holes of the round, he was 9 under par. Starting on the 18th hole, as went, birdie, eagle, birdie, legal, birdie, birdie, birdie. Both eagles were hold wedge shots from approximately 100 yards. A special thanks to Paul for his narration on this video.
This has been an OMF video production.